pleasure to be here, and as Asim knows, it almost didn't happen. Our Secretary of State is coming to India this week for meetings on Wednesday with the Prime Minister, the new External Affairs Minister, and the National Security Advisor. And originally he was going to actually land tonight, and that would have meant that I would have had to meet him at the airport, but fortunately that has been changed until tomorrow, so I'm so pleased to be here. One of the real surprises of coming to India is I've discovered that we don't just celebrate our Independence Day on July 4th, but we do it at various other days during the month of June and sometimes even into August. It's quite remarkable. I was told by people at the embassy that this is because in July we have people rotating in and out of the embassy, the weather gets worse, you have the monsoon season, people are often out of town. So we had our own Independence Day on June 6th this year. Our consulates are having them at different dates, and now I'm so delighted to be here on June 24th. When I eventually go back to the United States, I'll be completely confused as to what is Independence Day. But it's a real pleasure to be here with the IACC and the North India Council in particular, because of the very significant role that you have all played in advancing the U.S.-India relationship. Your founding members include one of my predecessors, Chester Bowles, and I think this may be the only organization that has one of the U.S. ambassadors as its founding members. And I've always been greatly impressed by the work of this organization and all that you've accomplished in your 51 years since inception, because I was at the 50th anniversary in Mumbai, so I'm delighted to be back here. And I certainly appreciate, again, everything that's been done, not just on the economic relationship, but on the strategic partnership more fully. Independence Day is an ideal time for Americans to reflect on the values that make our country so special. And these include individual liberty, free enterprise, an open society, human rights, and the rule of law. What's very special about being here in India is that I'm in a country that cherishes these very same principles. India recently displayed its commitment to democratic ideals when hundreds of millions of people made their voices heard in the largest democratic exercise in history. Our common values, it is often said, are the foundation that makes our partnership so durable and effective. Along with our shared interest, these values reinforce a strategic partnership that embodies what former Prime Minister Vajpayee correctly called natural allies. This is the second time tonight we're quoting from Prime Minister Vajpayee, so he was quite an important individual, and it was a true honor when I first worked with him when I was Under Secretary of Commerce in 2001. It's a privilege now to have the opportunity to work with all of you to solidify the friendship between our two countries that is exhibited by these values. I've been involved in the U.S.-India relationship for close to 20 years, not quite 51 years, but close to 20 years. And I've seen it grow and evolve from the perspective of a diplomat, a technology executive, and an investor. And from each of these perspectives, I've witnessed and appreciated the enormous opportunities that the relationship provides. Frankly, from time to time, there have also been challenges, frustrations, and ups and downs. But if you step back and look at where we were 20 years ago, or 51 years ago, and where we are today, the amount of progress we have made is truly remarkable. As was said by Asim, quoting someone I know well, the relationship today is as broad, complex, and rich in substance as any bilateral relationship in the world. And frankly, that's good news for lawyers, whether you practice tax or any other area. We work together on every issue out there: defense, nuclear non-proliferation, counterterrorism, trade, investment, energy, the environment, education, health, science and technology, space, the oceans, agriculture, and so much more. Perhaps most important, we have an extensive set of people-to-people ties, and that provides a very solid foundation for this relationship by bringing our societies so close together. Let me close by reiterating my thanks for all that the IACC does to enhance the economic relationship between our two peoples. Together, we are participating in and contributing to the most significant period, in my view, in the history of the U.S.-India relationship. I look forward to following up on the suggestions that were offered for how we can continue to work closely together with the IACC in continuing to build the strategic partnership between our two countries. Again, thank you so much for inviting me here, and have a very happy Independence Day. Thank you.